What's up, guys? 1UP James here. Today we're looking at Robophobic on the Nintendo Switch. Robophobic is a 70s sci-fi inspired top-down arcade shooter where you use tactical skills to avoid being surrounded by the robots as you unfold the story full of love, hate, and machines. The story is set during the early 70s where the government has created a robot city controlled by a supercomputer called PAL 9000, or PAL 9000, but we'll go with PAL 9000. Until one day, the PAL 9000 rebelled against man, capturing scientists and starting an evil plan to take over the world. You play as Julie, a rookie agent, and your goal is to find all your teammates and defeat the evil PAL 9000. The developers of Robophobic have done a decent enough job building up the sense of atmosphere through the story, which is played out through small cutscenes between each mission. As you progress through this soap opera scenario, six new agents are introduced into the story that become playable characters. Each of the six agents have their own playstyle, strengths and weaknesses, and special abilities. Although, they do use all the same weapons, so nothing is really different on that end. There are 10 different powerful weapons to unlock, each slightly unique in their own way. The variety of weapons will come in handy as you travel level by level through each of the 9 different locations of the game, where you will have to rescue 80 scientists as you make your way to the rogue AI known as PAL 9000. Each scientist you find will give you either a weapon or an armor upgrade as a reward. Health packs can be spread out in each level, but they are few and far between. Movement in the game is where a little more of the personality comes in. It's played out at a fast-paced turn-by-turn style, which will allow you to be somewhat strategic as you move around each level. Using a lot of timing and shooting in bursts covers most of what the combat has to offer, but the game pretty much allows you to move at your own pace, causing you to sometimes forget the turn-by-turn strategy and just try to plow through at your own speed. Although awkward, the availability to go at your own pace or slow down for more strategic gameplay has been a welcome. The level design isn't a whole lot to write home about, but each building does have its own design and each level of that stage their own multi-layered layout. Seeing it's a turn-based layout, the floors are sectioned in square style form to give you lanes and lines of sight. The enemies spawn out of the tiles and are then preceded with a counter for the respawns. Every step you take lowers the counter, getting you one step closer to enemies respawning, adding even more to the sort of tactical turn-based style of gameplay. There is a decent enough variety of enemies and mounted guns you will encounter, and a few unique boss enemies also. Though they do begin to feel a little repetitive, the variety in power and sheer number of them spawning on the screen will create a challenge time and time again. And the bosses do come at you with more life and power. That usually comes down to learning the firing and movement patterns. And with the attack radius of the enemies shown in yellow on the square tiles, you are always aware of the enemy's range. This mixed with being able to stop the game progress by standing still, you are always in control of the path you wish to take in Robophobic. The fast or slow paced gameplay and character selection, adding abilities like going invisible, with an interesting story with over an hour of cutscenes, Robophobic will bring you hours of fun. The only issue I had while playing Robophobic was some occasions where I wasn't lined up and shooting was inaccurate, which in all honesty, half the time was my fault. In the frame rate, it will drop when there is a large number of enemies on the screen. This does happen frequently enough, but isn't really that much of a problem. The game is no tremendous feat, but the fun gameplay and kind of interesting story is worth the asking price of $9.99 on the Nintendo eShop. Well, that's a quick look at Robophobic on the Nintendo Switch. If you enjoyed this video or found it helpful, drop a like. It really helps out my channel. Subscribe if you haven't already, and I'll see you next time, guys. Later.